will actually scare you. Because, I mean, at the end of that video, there's an image at the end. It is creepy as fuck.
I'd rather not. Let's resume now. Okay, now it's been a week and he's traveling on lit roads.
Okay, you're getting closer, 'cause I mean, like, he has to go into the house first.
I don't care if my electric bill went up for this. Should I keep on all the lights?
Yeah, but what if the lights go out?
Don't tell me that happened.
Oh, it's just a fun horror spew. Woo!
Right. Continue. Okay, he went downstairs to refresh his soda supply. Oh my god, I'm getting there, right?
Oh yeah, you're getting there.
Okay, shut up. Oh god, I don't even want to hear this, and I haven't heard it yet. Oh my god, catch a light bulb blue. Shit, it's gonna be right this next second, and I know
Yeah.
it. I keep pausing.
Keep
I
going.
need like mini breaks. Baby steps into this.
Marathoned that shit.
How could you?
I am
Are
a
you
professional.
insane?
I have never had sanity in my life, so there you go.
Sounds from the person who is afraid of zombies. All right, let's continue. There he was. Oh no. Oh no. He's inside. Fuck. Oh. Wait, that's not you, right? You're not making any sounds, right?
No.
Oh fuck, I thought that was you! I'm hearing it right now.
Ah!
Well, it sounds like a zombie.
Yes.
Oh. I hate how this is getting closer to my ear. I think I can handle the Walking Dead because I know that they're going to die.
You can't kill the Aspargo man.
Abstergo man. Why is he called that? What is Abstergo?
I have no idea.
I thought that was only an Assassin's Creed thing. Guess not. Okay, I'm getting a glass of water. Okay, now I'm back. I'm like so nervous.
Just wait until the second sound comes. The
Is that
second
near
time.
the end?
No, it just keep going. It's not near the end. It's sort of like 3/4 of the way.
One
And
question, does this guy die? He
maybe.
must.
Well, here's the thing is that the ending is ambiguous. You don't know because the story ends with the power going out.
He's dead then.
And because pretty much what happens is like that computer is sort of like he's pretending that he's recording himself telling the story. And then he's saying like, okay, well, all my TV, everything, like everything is on. So there's always light. And then suddenly everything was black. You don't hear anything. And then you hear the computer rebooting.
Oh no, you hear that shit?
Yeah, you hear that, but that's all you
Fuck.
hear.
Okay, let's continue. Oh no. As soon as I
shouldn't have worn headphones. I didn't wear any headphones last night, so it didn't bother me as much.
Oh, God. Okay. You know what? Headphones are coming out. They're gonna be the shit in it. Ugh. All right, can you hear me now?
I can hear you now.
Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Okay, wait. I'm not hearing you.
Can you hear me now?
Okay, yeah. I was on mute, that's why. Hello? I was like, wait, what? Okay, let's go back. Oh, shit.
It didn't take me long to flinch backwards and throw up. I turned around and scattered towards the door, reaching in a panic and almost pulling the thing off its hinges to get it open. The luminescence from the other room soon filled most of the dining room, and with it, the apparition left.
Thank God.
I've done some research on the back end of the internet describing what's been happening, as hypothetical situations, of course, and the only similarly related lore is the one of the Abstergo, or the Abstergo Man.
Ugh, fuck you.
A myth of a fallen angel that was condemned by the gods to wander the earth in search of the perfect person. If the person he chooses was perfect, then he would be free and allowed back into paradise. It seems he didn't get a good deal, as to find a perfect person is not an easy task, I can imagine. It is unknown what it does to anyone who doesn't fit this criteria, but I have a feeling I might find out. As the last time he appeared, he was within breathing distance.
What's happening now?
With the lights on, and as a precaution, a dozen lamps scattered around.
Wait, are you still hearing
it? Yeah, I'm still hearing it.
Okay. Oh, you gotta talk back. I'm getting nervous.
I muted purely for the screen lights, and my computer monitor as well.
Shit.
It's
no.
Hard as hell in here, but it's a small price to pay for the security it offers.
It's no price to pay. I get yourself, like,
so
with some people.
Nothing can get in and out of here. The only exception that I leave is around midday, when the sun is at its brightest, resupply food and water. I haven't been to work in days either, and I've ignored all calls coming through and people knocking on my door. What is there to tell?
These people are stupid. You can't be alone in these situations.
They can't help me. All I can do for now is survive while I research more into this legend. There are a lot of smart kids out there who know a lot about the old days. I've even found a subsection of a small forum dedicated to the Abstergo Man, and has some pretty interesting context from there. I've sent some emails to them, and I'm awaiting replies, so until then, all I have to do is survive.
No. 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 No, I paused it. No. No. The scenery was peaceful. Why did it have to change?
Yeah.
Not a good time to be wearing my short pajamas. I have goosebumps now.
Oh, that helped. This video I just sent you right now, it's actually a long, like, 4-part series. But
no, that should be a coping mechanism. That's what I need. I don't need any more of that shit.
Hey, I marathoned like over 6 hours of this shit. I'm fine.
How are you still alive? I can't.
Cause I'm amazing like that.
Ugh. I was not expecting the visual. Thank you. Okay, let's just finish this. It's only like a few seconds. Oh, wait. That's it?
Yep.
Oh, okay. The second one, though. Oh.
Told ya.
That was worse for me, though, because as soon as I hit play, it was like, it was right there.
Yeah, I bet that made you look over your shoulder and just like,
I, like, almost, like, ripped my headphones backing away from my laptop.